Guten Tag.
Hello, my name is Caroline Zöller. I am Managing Director of the agency for Team Communication. And it's my pleasure to inform you today on digital retail. Well, we talk about a new world of experience. It's about visual communication in the digital age. Our focus will be on retail and trade of today. Now let me tell you a bit about myself. What am I doing? I've been working as a consultant in the digital retail for many years, and I work with a large network of experts. We are carrying out a lot of management and trainings, and I have a close cooperation with the Retail Academy in Cologne. Together we, for instance, organize travel all over Europe to the heart of the trade to see the most important retail points in a city and to find out what's trendy. Moreover, we also give coachings about retail. And now I would like to take you with me to the digital world of trade. And right now I show you a picture that is not that good. It's on my way to my agency. It's in a shop window in a pharmacy, and there I can see the emergency service. And here, that emergency service, you see, you can hardly read it. For example, if the sun shines, that reflects, the cables are hanging down. That's not digital retail. That's simply not good. Good is, however, the Adidas digital store in London. The opening was last year in fall. It's in the Oxford Street. In that shop, there are around about 100 digital touch points, and they are in a way included that you hardly notice them. And there, for instance, if you go to the dressing room and present and check your clothes you selected, the mirror tells you, hey, we have that in other sizes and in other colors. And here you can also see, what do I have? And then the mirror suggests other things, accessories. It's just like in Amazon's customers who bought this product also bought that product. That works via RFID technology. All the clothes in that shop are wearing the necessary tag that shows us what it has to show. Another core piece in the shop is an app I can download. Here I can call a consultant. That means somewhere I'm in the shop and I would like to know more about that or see it in a different size. And then with the app, I can inform someone to come and support me. But I can also make an appointment with a personal trainer and use the gym there. So also a digital touch point, really great. I have categorized all that in 5 points that matter when we talk about digitalization in retail. It's about emotions, it's about product presentation, it's about customer convenience, interaction, and finally the experience. We'll start with emotionalization. The Kit Kat Chocolatery in Australia, they opened just a few time ago a brand store, and here I find 30,000 different combinations of chocolate and chocolate bars, rare things, just like chocolate with wasabi. Sounds a bit strange to European ears, but anyway, people like it, and I can create on a screen my personal chocolate bar. I can say I would like to try this and taste that, and I can even create the packaging. That means I can write my name upon the packaging, and the clue is, from the shop I can take a look to the experimental kitchen and see how my personal chocolate bar is being developed. That costs a 7 Australian pound, pretty expensive, but people accept it because they love it, they want to have their personal bar. A not so young example is an exhibition presentation from Stabilo and Crayola. Here we want to talk about how can I make interaction with the people. And on the exhibition ground, they had an app, We Are Carless. And so you can collect plastic in the sea, and that little video shows you how that works. I could draw my fish and then I can see my fish, sie ist swimming through the sea and collecting plastic, doing something good. And this is how I get the people to interact. And of course, I use just the Bilo pencils, which I can paint my fish. Next example is L'Occitane. It's a French cosmetic brand. And in Tokyo, they opened a brand store, and many Asian people have never visited Europe. And as you can see here, they did a lot about decoration, working emotionally with wood and plants. And there is a room you can enter to lift the product and at the same time be in the Provence. Here you see the products standing on the table, and when I touch them, something is moving on the table. I can see what kind of herbs have been used in the beautiful cosmetic boxes, and at the same time, I have a beautiful landscape around myself, and I am, well, it's I make a trip to the Toscana. But that also goes in a smaller ground. Here we see a little boutique in Paris. That's a selected shop created by an online, by a YouTube star. And she installed a little photo box in her shop. You can take a picture here with the colleagues. We took pictures. The good thing is you can print it immediately, but you can also send it via email. And also here I can see with something respectively small, I can make people interact with the shop and create an experience. However, the entire thing also goes vice versa. That means we show you rare examples. Uniqlo is one of my favorite negative examples. They are, of course, very digital already in the shop in Berlin too, but they have digital info screens. There you can see in what countries and cities Uniqlo can be found. And they have installed their digital info screen also alongside the stair. And, well, you hardly see the stairs, so it's really a risk to fall and to break a leg. That's nothing I would appreciate. So never forget, how do you use digitalization and the features, and when does it become dangerous so that people, for instance, fall down a stair? No good idea, I think. So one more time, the wrap-up for emotions. You have a creation, positioning and developing a brand, create a longing and customer needs, surprise customers and make them smile, and make customers be your fans. Second point, product presentation. Here you see my all-time favorite. It's an old example because the technology exists since 2010. It's the Lego box in the brand store in Cologne. Last year, you could see what's inside the products. That means I see the Lego box, and an augmented app on the screen, I can see what's inside and what I can build from the parts included in that box. The box wears a marker, the screen has a little camera, you bring both together, and here are the results. Good example, I think. A new thing is H&M Local, because H&M are trying a lot, and here in Berlin we have a new store opened last year. It's in Berlin Mitte. And here you can see a selected variety of products, different deco articles, designers from Berlin can present their products. And behind there is a little coffee shop where I can have a coffee and talk to my friends. And exactly this is where digitalization takes place. There I find screens where I can find information on the product range and where I can take a look on exclusive selections and collections. For example, if I need a special exclusive wedding dress, I could rent it there. That's a new feature by H&M. They focus very much on rent service. And here, via the screen, you as the customer can do that by yourself. Made is an online furniture seller. And they have recently collaborated with a tech company. That was 2015 in London. They opened their brand store and I don't see any price tags. So I have to take my iPhone and see that little black tag with the logo from the company, and then I scan it, and so I can get all the information on the product. I can see in what colors it exists, and then I can find the price, I can order, I can make a list, all things that are very easy to handle because I can take that home with me and later on make my decision. Good is also a wall there that combines the digital and the real world. And in every little drawer, you find all the textile patterns the furniture is covered with. So for instance, if my sofa has a red textile pattern, I can take it with me and see at home if that fits.
Passt das alles für mich zusammen und auch den Stoff nochmal wirklich haptisch erleben. Hier ist jetzt
here, during the collaboration, the tech collaboration, I can see on the big screen the furniture I selected, and they also have the sort of Instagram photo possibility. That means I see a picture on Instagram and here I can check if they have it and or if something is similar to that. It's called Shop the Look.
Also auch eine sehr schöne,
and then
sehr schöne
the screen Anwendung. Suggests me the things that fits. That's a good idea, good app. And also here I can offer you a negative example, that's Paul and Pear, a fashion producer in Frankfurt, and in their shop they welcome the customers behind glass. That means the welcome screen is hidden behind glass stones, and that's how digitalization is not used well, because if I'm outside, I hardly recognize what's on the screen. So product presentation, what matters? It's information and communication on product details. I can tell especially and clearly what is my product about. I can show a great variety of products. I have the endless aisle, that means this product you can find in other sizes and colors. I can personalize and I can configure. Then, here already we can talk about customer convenience. So I have a good example from the Walmart virtual store. It's from 2012, so not a young example, but it's very interesting because it's great for the customers. In the shop window, you can see the products with a QR code. So that means you do not only get all the information without entering the store by using your phone, but you also can realize your purchase, your Christmas gifts buy, also outside the regular shopping hours. That all started with apps in Asia in the food sector. Here you can see how it works. That was in Asia in an underground station. While the people were waiting for the underground on a big screen, you could just by passing by order your food and they delivered it. Next example is in New York. It's Rebecca Minkoff. It's a luxury fashion, luxury accessories. It's a great shop in New York, and in the store they welcome you on a large screen. The interesting thing is the dressing room, because there you have many choices. You can make your setting for the light, you can choose the language, and then they show you the products via the mirror and you are all alone. Maybe you take your decision, your example, want, for instance, you want to buy that bag, and then just carry through your credit card, check out, and you're ready to go. And then you leave the shop, you have one station left, where you have to take off the security tag, and then you're already wearing your bag on the street. Happily. So, the complete purchasing process, completely digital, and anything is included.
Hier ist eine kleinere Anwendung auch, die ich gerne
zeigen möchte. Now let's go to a shoe shop in Amsterdam. A little app I would like to show you. 2016, we were traveling with a store tour, and here we found something where you can scan your feet to see how is the structure of your foot and what Echo shoe fits you best. Here you have a little screen, and they make suggestions on the screen. So, and if you find something that suits you, you can say, hey, Echo, keep my data. Because like that, I can always and in everywhere Echo store all over the world, I have the data about the shoes and the brand that fit me. Also here, negative example. And it's from Chibo in Germany. Thank God, that was quite a long time ago. I can't remember exactly when, but better that. This has nothing to do with digitalization and a beautiful feature. This is just an ugly display, including an iPad, and it's hard to get there, and it's difficult to order something, because if I use the iPad, I end up on their website of Chibo, which was usually made for a larger screen, so it's difficult to use. And simply order something, no, that does not work here well, and it does not look good. So if you do something like that, please think of the customer and make it pretty. So customer convenience, here's my wrap-up. Additional services is something I can offer. I can omni or even multi-channel ideas present behind it.
Customer convenience,
reach the people at home, lure them to the shop. It's about navigation and helping people to orient themselves. It's customer convenience, and what I offer should be relevant and of importance. And I have to take into consideration the so-called pain points. That means make it as simple and as comfortable as possible for the customer. Fourth point, interaction. Here we go back to a Lego example. How can I make my customers interact with me via the shop window? There was a promotion around Easter, as you can see with the bunnies. And the customers were invited to play a game with a figure inside the shop window. The customer could fight the figure, and with moving your hands, you could collect points, make scores, and they wanted to see who is faster, you or the little figure, the animated figure. Good example for interaction. Great, good example for a flagship store in Tokyo is Hi Panda. That's a fashion label that completely presents itself with augmented reality, and there is the panda. He guides you through the shop. Now we can see that on the video how he's doing that. So here we see also a good example how I can walk through an experience world, how to can get in touch with the brand and the product. And if I want to know how it goes on, I will find it there. And now also here a negative example, that's Warmland in Berlin.
Das ist in der Mall of Berlin.
In the Mall of Berlin. Here they have a shop window, and down on the corner I find a little point telling me scan the QR code of Wormland. I can do that 24/7, but I would have to knee. That means me as the customer, I would to go on my knees before the brand, and then finally I get this. So that's a horrible example, because the customer is doing the scan, he's taking a bow before the brand, and then he gets nothing. No good idea. So interaction, reach your customers, keep in touch with them, entertain them, and use the word of mouth, inform them via your own community. Just think of the brand example of the Panda. Then, final point, the experience. I have an example from Hugendubel in Munich. Hugendubel was thinking, how can I make my customers come to my store, and invented a mobile game and sent it to its customers and combined it via geo-targeting that was around the shops. That means when I was passing by, I was informed that, hey, something's happening in the shop, download my app. And when you did that, you could collect butterflies. It was extremely successful. You had 100,000 gaming sessions, 22,000 hours were played by the customers, and 7,000 people were participating. And those who collected enough butterflies received little gifts. It's a very good example for interaction. Also very nice, the SAP Data Kitchen, the restaurant, digital restaurant in Berlin. They are specialized in lunchtime, and they thought, okay, so your lunch break is short, you don't have much time, how can we do that as good as possible, as easy as possible for the customers? Here you can eat something very tasty, you order your food via app, you get a time slot, and then you receive a personalized box showing your name, and there you find your food, your meal, fresh and warm, and via app you open the box and enjoy your lunch break. Very good idea. This is how you can use digitalization in the food sector. Great idea. But also here, negative example in the Mall of Berlin. That's a great shopping mall in Berlin. You see an impressive building and with many shops, and to find a way, they have a digital system. You see it down in the middle, you see a couple before a screen. Obviously, they are looking for something, and you see they need to take a bow to search. So, no good idea, because how can the customers find easily the information without damaging your bag? So please always take a look on these things too. Experience, the wrap-up, surprise customers, reinvent yourself again and again, make a transfer of information via emotions, be talk of the town, just like Panda, for example. And the resume is, if you use technique, digitalization, don't use it for its own sake, because there are so many great things when it comes to technique. It's about using techniques useful and reach your customers, support your purchase with digital tools. Think very well, what is it I would like to do, and support my customers, and then I can create experiences, making them emotional. I can motivate your fantasy, I can invite you to play, and I can combine online and offline, so that customers are being picked up at home 24/7. And like this, I can finally improve the purchasing experience to customers. A purchase experience shall be attractive, showing a service, and be helpful. And this is simple, as you can see in my final example. It's a shop window from Hermes. There is not much to product, a screen, a ventilator, and a beautiful content. It's not much, but it tells me exactly what the product can do. It's a beautiful silk scarf, and through its volatility, it's fascinating. And that's what I have to say. Thank you very much for listening. I hope I could give you some information. Thank you very much, and have a nice day.